What in week is this next question? Because it's from Joker Jack in Welch, West Virginia, who also his P.S. I'll add that first. Did you realize that Peter O'Toole is a double phallic name? Thank you for that, Joker Jack, jolly Joker. But anyway, he says, after falling asleep watching the current booking of WWE, I wanted to watch some real wrestling. So I went to YouTube and started watching some NWA wrestling from the 80s, which is what I grew up on. So I got to some 1987 stuff around the time of Magnum T.A. Zaxton and Nikita Koloff had turned babyface. During this time, there was a new wrestler introduced into the promotion, Vladimir Petrov. He was huge, and I thought even bigger than Nikita he was, actually. Who was this guy, and did he have anything else after the NWA stint, which wasn't that long? And did he and Nikita ever have a match? I think that was the match being built for the time. Any information would be appreciated. Thank you, as always. Well, Vladimir Petrov, his name was Al Blake. And he was from Minnesota. I know, imagine that. When things started changing around, Magnum had the accident. Dusty switched Nikita babyface to take his place. That left Uncle Ivan, Crush Khrushchev, Barry Darso had already left by that point. Uncle Ivan needed a nephew. They needed to replenish the Russians, and also they got the idea, they being Dusty, I'm pretty sure, exclusively, that he could build another Russian heel to have the, you know, basically now that Nikita has embarrassed his Russian comrades, here comes this, you know, even bigger Russian, like the old, you know, Terminator. Here comes the new Terminator, right? So I don't know. I'm sure it was he was an Eddie Sharkey. There's that gene pool, right, with the Road Warriors and Rude and Darso and all those guys. Here comes Al Blake, who is Vladimir Petrov. And I would say of all the guys that came from Minneapolis, and it's been talked about how that they, none of them had a really long breaking in period. And they kind of really didn't realize what they got into at the start, right, with wrestling. Big Al Blake's breaking in period was probably the shortest of the bunch of them. I don't know how long this guy had been training. He was a nice guy. I don't know how long he'd been training. I don't know how long he'd been watching wrestling, but he was a goddamn beast. He wasn't as tall as Nikita, I don't think, but he was, you know, over 6 feet, but he was just pumped. He was massive, 300 and something pounds, just huge. But I would say he was probably the most boring Russian in history of Russian wrestlers. Because he had no showbiz about him. He didn't know what he was doing. He didn't even obsess over it like Nikita did, where Nikita would speak in the accent, even on the plane, just with the boys, Crockett's plane, and in the locker room, and he obsessed on it. He became the Russian nightmare, right? Vladimir Petrov just came down there for a fucking job. And so there was no emotional connection, and he was trying to learn, but it just – so anyway, that's also at the same time. Remember, 87 is when Crockett's business started going sideways and south. And so one night, me and the Midnight Express, Greenville, South Carolina had been a great town through the years for Crockett. They ran it every Monday night at the Greenville Memorial Auditorium, 52 weeks a year. That town had grossed over $600,000 for wrestling in 1986 when they stopped running it every week. So that was for less than, that was like for 40 shows or whatever. And it when they got a big card, it would do huge, 5,000-6,000 people. But this was the time where the Carolinas towns were starting to get left behind by some of the bigger markets, and they were running two shows a night. And Greenville had a string of shows that just, it was brutal. It was like, you know, the Midnight Express versus the New Breed was the main event, plus others. Or on this particular night, I honestly think it may have been Vladimir Petrov versus Nikita Koloff. I don't know that for sure, but I know that Vladimir Petrov was in the main event and the Midnight were on the card, I think with the New Breed or something like that. And the house was... Greenville had done 60 grand for the Great American Bashes. Greenville had sold out for the big Christmas shows, 5,000 plus people. The house for Greenville this night was $3,200. It was barely 300 people, right? And so we're all sitting in the locker room, and then there's poor Vladimir Petro, old Big Al Blake, and he just don't know what he's got into. And he's sitting around with all these guys that are bemoaning. He don't know what the fuck. We're saying, oh, they've killed the fucking town, right? I used to do the Untouchables narration, the Walter Winchell fucking late that night in the South Side apartment of Al Capone's gangland enforcer, Frank Nitti, or whatever the fuck, right? To entertain the Midnight Express. So I'm sitting there late that night. In the Southside Chicago apartment of Frank Nitti, Al Capone's gangland enforcer, a meeting was held to determine who had murdered the town of Greenville, South Carolina. Capone's forces blamed Vladimir Petrov, the fake Russian from Minneapolis. Little did they know that the Midnight Express and the new breed had secretly killed the town the week before. And he said, he's sitting there, what the fuck? Everybody's laughing. We're just, he didn't get it. He didn't get anything. And he, one day he just wasn't there anymore. And I don't know that anybody ever saw him again.
The last I heard of him was a couple of years later in the Observer, in the readers section. Remember the readers pages where yes. There were letters, but also people could list things they wanted to trade or sell, whatever. I think Al Blake was listing that he was trying to raise money for his legal defense fund. In the Observer readers pages, because some sort of a big drug deal, cross state lines. The
usual. Oh shit, that's right. That's yeah. Right. There was some kind of, he was involved, not while he was wrestling for Crockett Promotions in Charlotte, I don't believe, but there was some kind of big brouhaha like that, big interstate trafficking. Yeah. Well, he had to have a you know, after he was a bouncer, then he was a wrestler, and he had to have a profession to fall back on.
I guess he couldn't call Uncle Ivan to bail him out.
Poor Uncle Ivan. Uncle Ivan, there's like 50 years old at that time, and he's still out there having to be the one to take bumps for the team. And it was brutal.